Hello everyone, this is Stephanie. Welcome to another video. So we're continuing on with the Cellini spiral. So remember we did the flat Cellini. We did the hematite heaven, which is, it's not a Cellini spiral, but it's, you know, it's the sculpture of peyote, right? And then we did the flat Cellini. And now we're doing the full Cellini. So I did a how-to on the Cellini spiral, but just how to do the how to actually make a spiral. I made this necklace out of that spiral. Okay, so this is all one thickness. So I started this one, which we're going to do today in this video, and this is a graduated Cellini spiral. So we're using bigger beads here, and then we're graduating up to smaller beads so that it has this nice graduated look. So right down at the bottom, you know, you've got this big, chunky, yummy spiral. And then as it goes up your neck and around your neck, it gets thinner. And then you have some fire polish beads here to make it comfortable around the neck and a little toggle on the end. So I clearly haven't finished the sample yet, but we'll work on a piece just like this. And ultimately, we want it to end up like this. So we just have the other side to do. But we're going to graduate it, and we're going to learn how to put on, how to make this peyote cup. So this is the little cup, remember, I showed you in the last video. And I put a nylon-coated wire through the beadwork and then did a crimp and a toggle. And it's just one way of ending it. I just thought it was kind of cool. You know, as I said in the other video, I wasn't that crazy about the cones. I have a bunch of cones, but I just didn't like the way they looked. So I thought, well, let me just figure something else out. So this is just something that I came up with. I hope that you enjoy it. So we'll make this a quick intro. So we're going to work on this. And when we come back, we'll get a materials list going and we'll get started on this necklace. It's going to be called the Spiral Path Necklace. Okay, see you in a minute. Okay, let's get a materials list started. So we'll start with the seed beads. So we need an 11-0 seed bead, and this is a Miyuki nickel-plated. And where I have the numbers, I will put the numbers in the description box below the video. I don't always have the numbers, but if I have it, I will put it down there. So this is a Miyuki nickel-plated 11-0. Then I have a Miyuki opaque black 11-0. I've got a Toho 8-0. And this is antique silver, and I just like the Toho color, so it doesn't really matter if it's a Miyuki or a Toho, they both fit. Then I've got a 6-0, and this is turquoise blue Picasso Miyuki. I've got a 4mm hematite bead, and this is an actual hematite, it's not a, it's a round bead. The round fits really nice in this, but I think you could probably try others. You can do a crystal, but I like the, you know, I kind of like the hematite bead. Okay, and because we're doing a graduated necklace, we're going to reduce the size of a couple of the beads. So we have a turquoise blue Picasso 8-0, same as the 6-0. So we're going to reduce, we're going to switch the beads out here. And then I've got a 3mm round hematite bead. So these are the two beads, the turquoise blue Picasso and the hematite beads, that we're going to go down in size, and the rest of the beads are going to stay the same. But that's going to give us a nice graduated look. Okay, you're going to need some 3mm bicones, and these are Swarovski crystal silver knight, just for the edge of the cup where you do the end. We're going to need some fire polish beads, and I have a 10mm, an 8mm, a 6mm, and I even threw a 4mm in. We may not use all of these, but you just want to graduate it. That's a little round one. You want to graduate the sizes. Well, I can't find my little 4mm, but you'll need a little 4mm. Oh, here it is. Okay. There we go. So I have a 10, an 8, a 6, and a 4, and we'll see how they look. And then I have a little round 4mm. Just, you know, you just want to see how they look at the end. So you're going to graduate those also. You can really play with these beads, but this is just sort of, this is what this necklace has. Okay. You're going to need some of these daisy spacers, and these I've had in my stash forever as these fire polish for 20 years. and these also, so I can't tell you where to buy them, and I don't even know what size they are, but they fit great in between these. If I can, you know, these are pretty common beads, so I think you could probably find them. I'll look online and see if I can find sizes here. I don't know how many you need of these, but, you know, you're going to put them in between these, the fire polish beads, just for a little accent. Looks pretty. Need a little clasp. I say, you know, you don't want a huge clasp on this because it is a pretty big necklace. So, and you want it to, it's going, the clasp is going to be around the neck. So you want it to be comfortable on your neck. So I think this one will be okay. If not, you know, you can try a different one. Whatever works. I'll see how it looks at the end. A couple of crimp beads because we are going to use wire to put this together. So here's some wire, and this is coated nylon coated wire. This is, I've had this forever as well, so don't ever throw anything out or say, I'm never going to use this. You will use everything you ever buy. I don't care what it is. I know I have. This is a 7-strand, it's 0.20, I'm sorry, it's 0.020 diameter. The label is worn off, so I'm not exactly sure, but I think you can use any wire on this pretty much because it's a pretty substantial necklace, so I think it can handle anything. And some 8-pound fire line. I'm using 8-pound because the small speed we're going through is an 11-0, and I think that 8-pound is fine for that. And it's a substantial necklace, so you want a strong thread. This is a size 11 beading needle, but you can use a 10. I just happen to have 11 here. Okay, let me just make sure I have everything. Anything I forgot, you always put down there, so always look. Okay. All right, so why don't you gather up your goodies, and we'll get started making this necklace. Okay, so we're back, and I've laid my beads out in the order which I'm going to pick them up, and we'll get to that in a minute. But what we're going to start on this is we're going to start on this piece right here with the 4mm hematite beads. So I have here the 2 11-0 seed beads, the 8-0, the 6-0, and the 4mm hematite. We're going to switch beads as we do this sort of graduated part. But I think starting in the center is always, I like it because that way if I want to change one end, I can change it if I want to. So it gives me a little, and size, fitting the way it fits, you can kind of play with that a little bit. And so if you have a few more options. So we're going to start with this big baby part right here. Okay. All right. So I have my beads out. All right. I've pulled in a little bit so we can get pretty close for this. So this is the sequence I'm going to put on my needle. I'm going to take 4 of the 11-0 silver, 2 of the black, 2 of the 8-0 antique silver, 2 6-0, 2 4mm hematites. Now I'm coming back down the line again. I'm going to skip this. I'm not putting any more of those on. 2 more 6-0s. 8-0s, and 2 more black 11-0s. I'm not going to put any more of the 11-0 silver on, nickel, because I already put my 4 on to begin with. So that's 2 rows right here, 4 beads. Okay? I'm going to bring those down. Got a little stop bead on with about an 8-inch tail. You're going to add beads because we're doing the center first, so you're going to be adding on thread here. You're going to be adding on thread everywhere. So use as much as you can for each, you know, each time, and we'll just add some thread. All right, so we're gonna, this is what we have. We'll go through this one more time. 4 11-0 silver, nickel, 2 black 11-0, 2 silver 8-0, 2 6-0 turquoise, 2 4mm hematite, 2 turquoise, 6-0, 2 8-0s, and 2 black 11-0s. So we're going to make that into a circle. Just bring it around just like this. Okay. So through the first 2 beads, those 2 silver beads, just like that. Okay. Just hold it. Give that a pull. So now you have a circle. Just like that. All right. So we're going to do a little peyote now. Just move this. Oops, sorry about that. Okay. So now we're going to do a little peyote. And what we're going to do with Cellini Spiral is the rule is the bead you're coming out of is the bead that you're going to put on next. So the bead my thread is coming out of is this silver bead right here. So I'm going to pick up a silver bead. Now I'm going to do peyote. I'm going to skip the next bead and go up the next bead, which is a silver bead. It's going to pop that into place. It's going to be a little wonky at first, so I'll just give a little pull, just like that. All right, so I'm coming out of a silver right there, my thread. I'm going to pick up a silver. I'm going to skip the next bead, which is a black bead. I'm going to go through the next bead, which is black. Give that a little pull, just like that. Coming out of a black, I'm going to pick up a black. I'm going to skip this 8-0 silver, go through the next 8-0 silver. Coming out of a silver 8-0, pick up a silver 8-0, skip the next bead, which is this 6-0 turquoise, go to the next bead, just like that. Coming out of a 6-0, pick up a 6-0, skip the next bead, which is a 4mm, go through the next 4mm. Notice I kind of push them over a little bit. I'm not pulling super tight right now because I think it, for me anyway, and I'm probably for some of you, keeping it flat at the moment is, you're going to see the beads better. So I kind of just keep things flat for the first couple of rows, okay? So you're coming out of a 6-0 right here. Excuse me, a 4mm. Pick up a 4mm. Skip the next 6-0. Gonna pull my stopping up a little bit just so I can see it easier. Okay, so we're coming out of the 6-0, pick up a 6-0, skip the next bead, which is a 8-0 silver, go through the next. I find if I keep my thumb on it, it holds everything in place. Go through the next bead, which is a 8-0 silver, just like that. Okay, just pull that over a little bit. Coming out of the 8-0 silver, pick up a silver. Skip the next bead, which is this black bead. So we're getting down towards the end of the row now. So skip this bead here, go through the next bead, which is a black bead, right there, just like that. Skip a bead, go through the next bead, and then pull, just like that. Okay, coming out of a black bead, bead. Now we're going to do our step up. So we're coming out of this black bead, and I'll pull in really tight for this, just for this bit here. Coming out of this black bead, we're going to skip this silver bead right here. See that one? And we're going to go through the next silver and then up on the diagonal through that other silver, just like that. I'll leave that for a few seconds for you to see it. So coming out of the black, skip that silver, go through this silver, and then the one on the diagonal. Come on through. Put that one in place, just like that. And that's what you have. All right, we're still staying kind of flat. So I'm going to pull out just a teeny bit just to get us back to where we were. So now we're going to do the same thing. We're going to put the same bead on that our thread is coming out of, only we're just going to go through the sticking out beads. So if you need sort of a reminder of what they are, just use your sequence here. Keep them all in a row if you can. So we're coming out of a silver, pick up a silver, go through the first sticking out bead, which is going to be a silver. Okay, coming out of a silver, pick up a silver, we're going through the next bead, which is a black. Okay, I'm just going to pull that over a teeny bit, just like that. Coming out of a black, pick up a black, you're going through the next bead, which is this antique silver 8-0. Okay, coming out of an antique silver 8-0, pick up the next bead, the 8-0 antique silver. You're going through the next bead that's sticking out, which is this one right here. Just like that. So all these little things, you know, these little sort of tips that you do or little tricks, just help you get them, you know, the beads in place. Because sometimes it can be a bit confusing. I'm still keeping this flat. It would curve right up if I pulled. But I just want to, I think you could just see the pattern better when it's, when you keep it somewhat flat. Okay, so we're coming out of the 6-0. Pick up the 6-0. Going through the next sticking out bead, which is this bead right here. All the way over here, this bead. See your sequence? Like I said, I'm not pulling them up yet. I will soon. They're going to have to pull soon. Okay. I just want to get you around to the step up. Coming out of the 6-0, the 4mm. Pick up the 4mm. Go through the next bead, which is this 6-0. Going back down again. I mean, don't rely completely on your sequence. Just use them all these little tips as little tools that, you know, help you, you know, if you happen to get lost or you're like, where do I go next? What bead do I put on next? Okay, coming out of a 6-0, pick up a 6-0, go through the next sticking out bead, which is the 8-0. Remember, you're always picking up the bead that your thread is coming out of. Okay, here's my thread coming out of my 8-0, pick up an 8-0, go through the next sticking out bead, which is this black bead. Okay, coming out of the black bead, pick up the next bead, which is you're picking up a black bead, and then we're going to step up again, so I'll pull in a teeny bit. Okay, so we're coming out of this bead, we've picked up a black bead, we're going to skip this silver bead right here. See this guy right there? Right there. I'm going to go up through this one, and then this one. I'm going to hold it there for you for a second. Okay, so we've stepped up. Always going to step up in the same place. Now, what you can do at this point is you can start to curve it. So put your thumb in and give it a little, pull the thread all the way around, and your piece should start to curve in just like this. Okay? So we're starting to get a spiral here. And it can get a little bit, you know, confusing. So you want to make sure that you're nice and, you know, that your spiral is staying in the right sequence, and that you're, you know, and it, so it, after the first 6 rows, it will be quite clear. Now you can put it on a pen or a pencil. That one didn't work. Let's see about this one. I did this in the how-to video. We put it on a pencil. This pencil is a little narrow for it, but I can give it a shot. All right, so starting another row. Coming out of a silver, pick up a silver, go through the next sticking out bead, which is a silver. Okay, just like that. Give that a pull. Coming out of a silver, pick up a silver, go through the next sticking out bead, which is a black. Okay. Coming out of a black, pick up a black, go through the next sticking out bead, because remember, we're curved now, so you have to, you know, you're going to look for your sticking out beads here, okay? It's going to go through it's going to be this one, it's going to be a silver bead, okay? Coming out of the silver, pick up a silver, going to be going through this one, right? This 6-0. Now, if if that's not all that healthy too, just hold it and just pull. Okay? Coming out of a 6-0, pick up a 6-0, go through the next sticking out bead, which is a 4mm. Okay? Coming out of a 4mm, pick up a 4mm, go through the 6-0. Okay? So now we're sort of set, so you're not going to sort of mess up and put them on. I mean, this is experience talking, where I've messed up and I've put them on in different places. So now we're pretty good. Okay, coming out of the 6-0, go through the next sticking out bead, which is the 8-0. Coming out of the 8-0, pick up the 8-0, go through the next sticking out bead, which is the black, right there. See that? Right there. Coming out of the black, pick up a black. Oops, I hope it wasn't out of frame. Skip the next silver, which is this one, and go up these two, this one, and then the one on the diagonal, just like that. Okay. All right, now you're ready for your next row. So you're just going to keep doing that. Okay, see how it's starting to curve? And it looks a little, you know, it, like I said, you try the pencil. Maybe it's helpful. I think whatever works for you, try it and see. So I'll just go around a little bit more just to get it going a little bit. There we go. Coming out of the silver. Go through the black. Okay, coming out of the black. Up a black, go through the... So remember, here's your sequence again, okay? Let me pull out a little bit. Okay, go through the silver. You don't want to skip anything. You want to make sure that every bead goes on. Okay, so you're coming out of the antique silver, go through the 6-0. Coming out of the 6-0. Go through the 4 millimeter, coming out of the 4 millimeter, go through the 6-0, like so. Okay, see how we're getting, see how it's starting to really spiral around now? And this happens after, you know, a few rows, and then at, once you get to this point, you won't have, you know, you won't question where your beads go. You'll just really be able to see it. So we're going through the, just be careful about getting caught with the pencil. It can be a little bit of a pain, but it's worth it if it's helpful. Just like so. Okay. Coming out of the 8-0, go through the black one. I'll do the step up with you. Just because the step up seems to be, that always trips me up. It seems to trip most people up. Alright, so here the step up being on the pencil is really helpful. So coming into the black, pick up a black. Alright, so we're going to skip, and here I'm going to pull on again one more time. We're going to skip this silver bead right here. See this silver bead? Right there, this guy. We're going to go through this one and up on the diagonal through the other one. Okay, there you go. Just like so. All right, so this is the start of our spiral. So go play. Go have some fun. Go do this. Let's see. We're going to adjust it a little bit as we go. So do the, keep going around until you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 6 spirals with the 4 millimeter beads. I kind of liked how that looked. Sometimes an odd number here is good to do 5, but I kind of liked 6, so that's what I did. So do 6 if you want it to come out like this, and then we'll play with the ends. Like we might take a couple of beads off, we might add a couple of different size beads on. We'll use the same beads that we, you know, that's in the materials list, but we might adjust them a little just to get the curve looking really good. So go play, get this done, get done your 6 little spirally guys, and then meet me back here, and we'll start to reduce use the smaller bead sizes and graduate our side pieces up. All right, have some fun. See you soon. Okay, so we're back, and I have just a little bit done. I'm not going to do the whole thing because it will take me forever. So I'm just, you know, sort of here, and let's say I've done with my, I'm done, you know, I've come to the end of my thread, and I want a new thread because I'm, you know, it's getting small here, and I want to add some thread on. So sometimes it can be confusing to add thread on with a spiral. So I found a little trick that helps me. I don't know if it'll help you, but give it a try. Here's my new thread. Here's my needle. I'm gonna put on a stop bead. These are all little tips that help me. I hope they're helpful to you. I'm just going to leave about a 6-inch tail, okay? And then I've stopped at the step-up, so I've done the step-up. There I am. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to sort of stake my thread, my needle through, just like that. Okay, and then I'm going to pull my thread through, just like so. Right. Still have my thread attached and my needle attached. I find that if I leave them attached, if I make a mistake or I need to fix something or something doesn't, you know, needs adjusting, I don't have to worry about taking it out. This way it's on there. I can always adjust it. I can always play with it a little bit. Yes, it has a couple of threads hanging around, but to me it's worth it to not have to start digging through to take something off. So I'm coming out of the silver. Okay, so let's stick a silver. Go through our black. Just like that. Okay, you can even hold the threads out of the way. All right, coming out of a black, pick up a black, go through the, oops. Make sure you just go through the black. Okay, pick up a black. Okay, coming out of the antique silver, pick up an antique silver, 8-0, go through the 6-0. Coming out of a 6-0, pick up a 6-0, go through the 4mm. See, it's easy now because everything is just spiraling nicely and you can tell what you're going to go through. So just, you know, be patient, and when you get to this point, it'll just be fun. I mean, it really is fun to do. 4mm, go through the 8-0. Excuse me, go through the 6-0. 6-0, go through the 8-0. Don't get caught, just like that. Okay. Go through the, pick up an 8-0. You're going to go through the 11-0 black. And see, your thread is on now. And you can sew it in at any time at this point. There. Okay. Coming out of the black. We're going to step up now, right? So here we're going to skip this bead right here. We're going to go through this one and step up. And that's all there is to it, to adding on thread. Okay, so let's just keep, we'll just keep going a little bit. Go through the next sticking out bead. The next sticking out bead. Oops. Just like that. Pick up black. Through the next sticking out bead. Coming out of the antique silver, go through the next bead, which is a 6-0. See, coming out of the 6-0, pick up a 6-0, go through the 4mm. That. You're going to be pulling this tight at this point. There, next sticking out bead. Just like that. Give it a pull. Next sticking out bead. Just like that. Coming out of the silver. Go through the, pick up a silver. Go through the black sticking out bead. Just like that. Pick up the black. I'm going to step up again. Coming out of this black bead right here, skip this bead, go through this bead, and the bead on the diagonal. Okay? So there you have it. You've added a new thread. Now at this point, you can sew in the threads that are, you know, the thread that was on the work and your new thread, and you're ready to continue. So go ahead and continue and get your four spirals done, and then we'll come back and we'll sort of adjust it and start decreasing. So for your next for the next segment, you'll need all the same beads. We might not use these. We might, or we might. I'm not sure. But you'll need your 8-0 turquoise beads and your 3-millimeter hematite beads. Okay. Have fun. See you in a few. Okay. So we're back, and I've done a couple of spirals, and just when you end on a step up. So I've already stepped up here, and I want to show you how to decrease. So we're going to do this part now. Okay, so here we are. So then we're just gonna sort of, we're gonna replace some beads to make it smaller, so that as it goes up, it has a nice gentle kind of decrease going on there, graduated bit there. All right. So where you stop at this point, I didn't count the beads, like 20 here or 10 there or whatever. I just looked at it. So I'll look at this, just give you an idea with this sample. I just looked at it, and I had my six spirals here, and then I thought, okay, so this is the front of my necklace. I'm going to start decreasing here. But you see, if I just move the necklace around, you could see where the beads get smaller, and where it lays nicely is really where you want it to be. Okay, so this is what we're going to do. Here's the piece. It's very simple. We're just going to replace the 6-0 and the 4-millimeter with an 8-0 turquoise and a 3-millimeter hematite. The rest of the beads are going to stay the same. The sequence is the same. Okay? So we've stepped up. Okay? So we're just going to do our regular, look, we're just going on doing the spiral. It's a silver, coming out of a silver, pick up a silver, go through the black, just like that. Coming out of a black, pick up a black, go through the 8-0. The silver, coming out of the silver 8-0, put on a silver 8-0. Okay, so to this point, we're all the same. So now, we're just going to switch to an 8-0 in the turquoise. Just one. Go through the hematite. Okay. Then we're going to take the hematite. We're going to go put the 3-millimeter on instead of the 4-millimeter, and then we're just going to continue just replacing these beads, you know, the 8-0s, the 6-0 and the hematite with the smaller beads. Okay, so coming around, just like that. So now we're going back to our regular beads. We haven't changed the other three beads. I'm just going to step up. Going. We have a silver, add a silver, we have a silver, go through the black, coming out of a black, go through the silver 8-0. Silver 8-0. I'm going to go through this, the 8-0 now. See, and it kind of graduates. You really, you know, you just don't see it. It graduates really nicely. Okay, so we're now doing the 8-0 now. So we're going to go through the 8-0, pick up the 8-0 and go through the 3-millimeter hematite. See how we're just getting a little smaller? Go through. Next bead. Going back down. Go through here. So that's all we've done, is we've just replaced those two beads. You can replace any beads. You know, you can, you know, change your beads. I think to make it go, you know, I think you need to do this center bead and the two side beads to give it continuity. So, or you can just do one bead. You can decrease very slowly. So I'm going to step up here. You can decrease slowly and just start decreasing just with your hematite bead. And then after a while, you can decrease, you know, you can start, then add the smaller 8-0. So it's really up to you. This is the pattern for this necklace, but there are a lot of options here if you would like to do it differently or make your that sort of graduated bit a smaller, in smaller increments or larger. So it's up to you. You can even do wavy, you can do all kinds of stuff. So this is what happens. See how it just starts to get a little smaller. And then you're just going to keep going. Keep going. Going. And that's simple. That's it. These spirals are so much fun because, you know, there's so many things you can do with them to change the shape. Okay. Just finish the end of this row. Oops. Kind of a black. I'm going to step up just like that. All right. So what's going to happen is, see how you've graduated down a little bit, and as you go, this piece is, you can already see it's getting smaller. It's going to graduate, and you're going to bring this all the way down. Now that's the only way I did it. I didn't make it even narrower at the end. You could, but I was kind of happy with the way this one came out. So that's what we're going to do. All right. So keep going and do this until you get to the end, and you're gonna. My necklace is going to be, and this is one in process. It's going to be 24 inches. Okay, so about. It's longer, but I think it needs to be. I don't like all that bulk up at my neck. So having it longer, it looks kind of pretty long. I like that. I can see with the black dress. So just keep doing it. So if I measure, I'll just give you a quick measurement. So I'm just going to measure the piece that I have. So my six little spirals, it's about 4 inches, okay? And then, so that's 4 inches of the 24. And then the part that goes up around my neck, or to a certain point to my neck, is 7. So that's 11 inches, okay? Let's say 6. Maybe we'll do this 6. So 6 inches, so that's 10 inches. So 6, 10, 16. You're going to do 6 on this side, 16. And then, just use my arm. Then this end, you're going to add this end on. Okay, so it may be 22 to 24. So just measure as you go along. Like, put this around your neck and see, where do I want this part to come around my neck? Do I want it to, do I want it down lower? Do I want it longer, shorter? And that's going to be up to you where it falls nicely, because I think it's important that these fall nicely on your neck and that it's comfortable around the back of your neck. Okay, so just a guideline, 6 inches of this, maybe 4 to 6 inches of this, 4 inches of the larger beads, 4 to 6-ish for the other side, and then a couple of inches for the fire polish beads. But right now, just get the graduated part done on one side, and then we'll do the little peyote cup so that we can get our fire polish beads on. Okay, see you in a few. Okay, so we're back. So now I finished just, you know, a decrease here, you know, where we sort of graduated a bit by adding the eight OC beads, and I'm just doing one little spiral, just so you get an idea. Here it is here. So here's where it, you know, it changes. All right. So we want to do this little peyote cup. It has some 3mm bicones in it. So I made a black one on the end of this, but I really think the silver would be better. And I think, not just better, but, and I think for filming, you're going to see a more matte color better. So I'm going to use these 11-0 turquoise beads, and these are turquoise blue Picasso, just like the 8-0s and the 6-0s, so I have them in all sizes. And we're just going to work on this end cap here, because then we're going to put our bead in, like so. Or, you know, they're going to sit in there. So let's get that started. So come to the end and step up, like we have stepped up before. Now, so it will, there will be continuity. You will use either your black 11-0 or your silver. I would suggest the silver. It's just the silver is so reflective that you really can't see it when I filmed it. I did try filming it, but I couldn't see it. So I'm going to use these, as I said, I'm going to use the turquoise beads. But yours will look better if you either use the black or the silver. I think is even better if you're using this combination. All right, so what we're going to do now is, I'm looking at my directions now. So we're going to start with one round of these 11-0 seed beads to put the seed beads in place for the cup. So we're coming out of the silver, pick up a turquoise, or in your case, you'll be picking up a silver or a black. And we're just going to put that bead in. Let's go to the next bead. And you're going to go all the way around. Putting this little turquoise 11-0 through all the sticking out beads. I'm just setting up for another section so that we can end this. So I'm just going around, just going through the same sticking out beads, only I'm using only the 11-0. Like so. Now I'm going to step up. So my step up, it's the same step up, it's just that because you're using all 11-0 and the turquoise, you just have to look for it. So here's the silver bead right here that you're going to skip. You're coming out of the black, you're putting on a turquoise. You're going to skip this bead and you're going to go up the silver on that first turquoise that you put on, that 11-0. Just like that. Right? And that sets your, see how that brings everything in? So now, you're just going to put on two more. I want to make sure that's right. I'm going to put on three more of the 11-0 seed beads, whether you're using the black, the silver, or you could even use this. I think it might look okay. So do three more rows, and then meet me back here, step up, and meet me back here, and we'll put on the bicones. Okay, see. Okay, so we're back, and I have my beads on. I might have put on an extra row here, but that's okay. I don't think it's all that important, the number of rows, just so that it looks good. So it's here we are with circular peyote, so it looks pretty good to me. So now we're going to put on some 3mm bicones. So just pick up a bicone and go through every sticking out bead. And you don't have to pull these super tight at this point. You can just kind of place them. You know, you're going to kind of force them in there a little bit. Like so. You want them to stick out a little bit because we want a sort of a cup formation. so we're coming to our last bicone. So we're going to go through this C bead right here, and you want to go up through the bicone, but I don't think it's going to, I think it's at a weird angle, so I'm just going to do them separately. So that's your step up. Okay, and now you want to pull them, but still I want to kind of cup it out a little bit, just like that. So now we're going to continue on with the seed beads. So we're going to put an 11-0 seed bead in between each bicone. Just come on around, and it's starting to tighten up and fit really nicely. Around. Kind of just puts them in place, locks them in. It's like that. So come on to the end, and we're going to come through this bicone right here, and we're going to step up that first seed bead. And now your cup is forming, see? And it doesn't look bad in the turquoise. I think I like the silver ending better, but I think this is much more viewable. All right, so we're coming out of this seed bead right here. So we don't need the bicones anymore. Let's just put those aside. All right? So coming out of a seed bead. So I want you to pick up two 11-0 seed beads. You're coming out of this seed bead. I just want you to hop over to the next one and come through just the seed bead. Just like that. See? Pull that through. Let that sit around the top of the bicone. Just like that. So you're kind of circling the bicone. Coming out of this bead, hop over to the next. 11-0. Don't forget to put two on. Through the next seed bead on the other side of the bicone, just like that. See how it kind of covers it? Pick up two seed beads. Coming out of this seed bead, go through the next seed bead. Okay, coming out of this seed bead, let's hop over to the next seed bead. Two seed beads. Coming out of this seed bead, just hop over to the next seed bead. And if they happen to kind of went through the wrong seed bead, go through this seed bead. Okay. Coming out of this seed bead, I'm going to go through the next seed bead right there. Just like that. Two seed beads. Through the next one, just all the way around. Last two. Come through this one and the one on the top of it. So you're sort of stepping up here as well to get to the top. Give that a pull. So now this is how it looks. Okay. I think, as I said, I think it looked better in silver, but I just wanted you to be able to see it. So then to reinforce this a bit, just go around the seed beads. You know, just sort of sew through a little bit. Come on up. Just go through your thread path here. and reinforce the top. Going down. You could even go through the bicones, whatever, you know, however it feels like it's tightening up, because this is, you know, a point of the necklace that you want to make sure it's nice and strong. So go around and reinforce this little cup, and then when we come back, we'll finally get our little beads on the end, and we'll have a finished necklace. Okay, see you in a minute. Okay, so we're back, and we're coming down to the wire. Speaking of wire, we're going to take our wire, and we're going to snake it through our entire necklace. Right, so you have both. I'm using this sample piece. I decided to go, you know, use the bigger one, but here's the one we were working on. Okay, so when I did this one, and let me see if I can pull out a teeny bit. Okay, I just snaked the wire right through, and it looks like it might not go through, but it went through easily. I just held it. It's hard for me to do this, but I held it like this, and I just let it dangle, and then I snaked it through, and I didn't have a problem. However, if you do have a problem, a good thing to have is a piece of a stiff craft wire, you know, like the or a hanger. But I think even the really stiff craft wire would work. And snake that all the way through your necklace, you know, the stiff piece, and then like tape this wire, you know, the flexible wire to it, and then just pull through, and your whole piece. The whole piece of wire will go through. So you can do this. I just snake it through because I like a little bit of a challenge. So, all right, so let's finish up. So here we go. I have a good thing to have are these little guys here. These are great for wire. Put it on if you're stopping in the middle and you don't want your wire to fall out. I have it on, now I'm working on this one, so I have everything, threads attached to it and all, because I want to complete this. So I put a wire at the other end. I will take this wire out before I finish, you know, complete it. So here we go. So remove if you have it clamped like that, remove it. Just hold it. And then you just want a number of end beads. Now I'm using 10 millimeters. That's the biggest I have. You could even go bigger, I think, to fit in depending how big your cup is. I think I could probably do a little bit bigger. This is a little bit smaller necklace, you know, a little bit narrower, so the 10 millimeter fit really perfectly right there. So maybe I'd go for a 12. I don't have one, so I'm just going to use the 10. But you can go for bigger. So I'm going to take that. I'm going to take a little daisy spacer, like so. Maybe take another one. And a spacer. Then I'm going to go down to, say, an 8 millimeter. And this is, you know, all design choice. So you can put whatever you want at the end. Maybe go for a 6 millimeter. And you also want to decide how much of this, the fire polish you want to show. You may want a lot of it to show down your chest, and or not. So, you know, play with it. So, you know, hold it up against you and see. You might want to do less of the graduated part and more of these. So this is why doing the centerpiece first gives you a lot of freedom to change things, because I'm always changing things. Like I might have made this one a couple of spirals shorter and done more of this, of the fire polish beads. So I might even take this out and, you know, before I complete the necklace, just to play with it a little bit more. So that gives you have that freedom to do it when you do this first, the larger part in the middle first, and then you can just play with it. So anyway, we'll just do this just for the sake of getting on the clasp, okay? So this is what I have. I'm going to take some 4 millimeters, so I've gone from 10 to 8 to, let's go 6. 6. Let's see. I think I'm always changing my mind. Not that it really matters on this, but I'm going to take one of the 10 millimeters off. And this is just, you know, design stuff, right? You're just going to play with this a little bit. So just put on whatever. 6. Oh, looks okay. And then I'm going to put on 1. I always like to end it with maybe 3 beads. You know, just coming down a little bit further. You know, just so it's comfortable around your neck, like this one. I did the 3 onyx beads at the end, and it makes it comfortable to wear. All right. So then what you want to do is you want to take your, here's your crimp tube. Let me move these guys out of the way. All right, so here's your crimp. And I'll, let me come in for this too. Okay. I'm going to go through the crimp tube, just like that. Put that on. And then I like to put a bead between the crimp and the, and when I put the clasp on. So I'm just going to put a little 8-0 seed bead there, and that's a little turquoise seed bead. I'm going to take my clasp. Now at this point you would put your wire protector on if you're doing a wire protector. I don't have one, so I'm just going to use the wire as my loop. But a wire protector would be nice. It'd look pretty, nice and finished. So come on around. Come through the 8-0, the crimp, and as many beads as you can. Might get a little tight, but that's okay. Just give it a little push. If you need to use your pliers to grab the end, just do that. This is pretty thick wire, so it's a little tight, but just use your, like I did, just use your pliers to pull it through. Go through another one if you can. You might have to also use your, try not to crimp your wire. Pull through. Okay, just like that. You can try going through another one. Okay, and even this one. Okay, so I'm just going to, whoops, pull this through, just like that. All right. So now I'm definitely in there really good. Okay. So just make sure that everybody's nice and tight. All right. So now what we're going to do is we're going to crimp. All right. So take your crimp tool, and I'll put this in the description box because I did forget to tell you about it earlier. And if you haven't used a crimp tool before, there's a really great way to use a crimp tool that, and it took me forever to realize this. There are 2 holes in the crimp tool. See that? And you, most of you probably know this. I'm just, you know, oblivious sometimes. And I've been doing this for years. So there's a hole right here that's closest to where this little cap is. And then there's one here. I want you to go through the second one. Put the crimp through that second hole. Just like that. So you see how that's sitting in the second, the hole that's closest to this. Make sure you have just the crimp in there, and squeeze. Really tight, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. That flattens it out just like that. See that? Now you see the first hole that's closest to the tip. Put it in this way. Okay, just like that. Can you see that? So you, and then squeeze. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Just like that. And you see what that does? It folds it over on itself. It makes it kind of like tube-shaped. And that's going to really hold it. So do it real tight, and then... So that's the best way to use a crimp tool. That's the only way to use a crimp tool that, you know, I, after doing this for years, just figured out. Clip it off. There you go. All right. So... Here's our mess. Okay. Just to give you an idea of how the turquoise one is going to look. They're pretty time consuming, but it's so worth it. It's so pretty on. It just, you know, it's a really nice, you know, substantial necklace, and it's a statement piece. I mean, you really, you know, you're really making a statement with this. Even though it's sort of subdued in its colors, let me pull out so I can get it all in the frame, make it look pretty, okay? So even though it's sort of subdued in its colors, it's a statement piece. And this one, I love. This is, of course, the Hematite Heaven, and this is all one. It's not graduated. It's all one thickness, and this is also a great, you know, way to do it too. And they feel great on your neck. Believe it or not, this is not heavy. It's weighted nicely, so it's not. It doesn't feel like it's hanging on your neck and pulling your neck down or anything. So I think that I think you really enjoy it. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you make this, or at least maybe use some of the techniques in this video. For when you do a Cellini spiral. I hope you subscribe to my YouTube channel, and take care, and I'll see you on the next video.